Let's face it, traveling has a lot of challenges. Sleep, digestion, and intestinal function can all suffer. So many symptoms, from puffy ankles to headaches and constipation, can occur. But the good news is that there are ways to prevent these issues from occurring. Hi, my name is Biggi Fraley. I'm the Arthritis Coach. Welcome to the show. Now, with the holidays just around the corner, I'm sure you have lots of travels planned, be it to see friends and family, or simply escape the winter somewhere to a sunnier spot. So I thought this would be a good time to share with you the keys to happy and healthy traveling. You see, learning to support your digestion, your intestinal function, and all the systems in your body does require some thought and planning. But there are many things you can do to support your body. So first, let's talk about the downside of travel. Now, it doesn't matter if you're driving or flying, both are hard on the body. But flying can cause many more issues because of the altitude, exposure to radiation, and the time changes depending on where you fly. So here's what happens. Your internal organs get out of balance. This is especially true when flying, as rapid changes in altitude throw off the internal pressure of the body. Now, this includes digestion and intestinal function. Exposure to light at night can throw off both your circadian rhythms and your internal electrical systems. Also, dehydration can occur. Both driving a long distance in a car and flying can cause the body to become dehydrated. We tend to drink less to avoid having to use the restroom frequently. When flying, the air is drier at high levels of altitude, and being in a car with closed windows and with a heater or air conditioner on also makes the air drier. Circulation is compromised in both the bloodstream and the lymphatic system. Both driving and flying have you sitting for long periods of time. This also causes inflammation to go up. Is it surprising that you are stiff and sore when you arrive at your destination? Next, you are exposed to more pathogens from being in close quarters with other people. This is the case when you are in a car and stopping at rest stations. It's worse in a plane, as people are all crammed together. Different areas have different pathogens that your system may not be used to. Did you know that cravings also go up? Since you're deprived of your usual health foods, you have fewer nutrients to support your body. Fewer nutrients, in addition to dehydration, can cause cravings for food and may lead to overeating. Now, the good news is that all of these issues can be counteracted. Just follow these 7 steps and you can enjoy a much better traveling experience. Number 1, stay hydrated. Adding electrolytes to your water and drinking about 50% more water than you usually consume will help immensely. If you don't have an electrolyte supplement, just use some Himalayan salt or other good quality sea salt. 1/8 of a teaspoon per 1/2 liter or 1/2 quart of water will suffice. And number 2, avoid excessive eating while in transit. When flying, try to avoid eating for at least 2 hours before flying and during the flight. The disruption to your digestive system because of the change in pressure and altitude can cause gas and bloating and leave you feeling sluggish. If you need to eat on a flight, then consume something light. Buy raw food bars or take digestive enzymes and probiotics with whatever you eat to aid digestion. Carry healthy snacks with you. If driving, eating is much easier. Make sure you don't eat in the car though. Go to a rest stop and eat in a relaxed, comfortable environment. When you drive, You have total control over what you eat, so take advantage of it. Fresh fruits and vegetables are ideal, as they will also help with hydration and are easy to digest. Number 3, boost your nutrient intake. This is where supplements can come in handy, especially when flying. Free radical damage is high due to the extra radiation exposure when flying and the car exhaust when driving. So take a good, high-quality antioxidant formula, also a good quality multivitamin and mineral formula will provide all the essential nutrients you need. Number 4, eat for balance. When eating food, consume good quality protein and fats with whole grain carbohydrates to help keep you satisfied longer and sustain your energy. This will help limit cravings and prevent overeating. When you arrive at your destination, go grocery shopping. Most hotels these days have small refrigerators in the room. Buy foods such as fruits, vegetables, hummus, and fermented foods like sauerkraut. You can add it to the hummus. This will provide lots of enzymes to aid digestion and help intestinal function. Now try to consume as many of the same foods as you possibly can that you would typically consume at home. Number 5, improve circulation and lymphatic flow. Sitting while driving or flying causes blood to pool and the lymphatic system to stagnate. Try to get an aisle seat on an airplane so you can get up frequently and walk up and down the aisle. You can also stretch your legs, arms, and torso while sitting in your seat. When driving, make sure to take frequent breaks and get out of the car to stretch and walk around for a few minutes. Once you arrive at your destination, go for a walk, at least 20 minutes. This will help improve circulation and will help you relax later when you wish to go to sleep. Number 6, overstimulating blue light. Now this can throw off your circadian rhythms if you are exposed to it from cell phones and notepads while flying at night or using your computer before bedtime. There are special blue light blocking glasses that can be purchased to cancel the exposure. Blue light disrupts melatonin production and lowers serotonin. Both can affect your mood and are a factor in jet lag. Sleep is important while traveling, and it takes a bit of adjustment if there's a significant time change. When taking a red-eye flight, bring a neck pillow for more comfort and an eye mask to block out light. Earplugs can be helpful too. These may also help with the strange noises that are always present in hotel rooms. And number 7, take digestive enzymes and probiotics. Enzymes and probiotics can be taken more frequently, even between meals. Enzymes aid digestion, which can often be out of whack while traveling. When taken between meals, these may help reduce inflammation, which often increases from poor circulation and stagnant lymph. Probiotics also aid digestion, support the immune system, fight pathogens, reduce inflammation, and may help prevent constipation or diarrhea. There are several self-stable brands you can buy. Just ask at your health food store for a good brand. Now, if you have a refrigerated brand already that works well for you, you can take it depending on how far you're traveling. See, a probiotic that requires refrigeration will lose 25% of its potency after 72 hours. This means that you could take it on a 4 or 8 hour flight and lose very little potency as long as your hotel room has a refrigerator in the room. For added protection, put the probiotic bottle in a small insulated bag with an ice pack and stick it in your suitcase. And one final tip. Carry a bottle of oil of oregano or grapefruit seed extract capsules. If you feel a cold or flu coming on while traveling, either of these can help you fight it off. They're also helpful for food poisoning, especially when combined with probiotics and fermented foods. So whether you're traveling for work or pleasure, it's no fun when you feel poorly and your body is out of balance. You've learned that traveling places a lot of physical stress and strain on your body. If you've been working on health on a health issue, especially gut issues, your trip may put all the progress you've made in jeopardy. However, if you follow the tips I've shared with you today, you can protect your body and feel great, allowing you to take advantage of all the exciting opportunities that await while you're away. Happy travels! If you enjoyed the show, please do share it on your favorite social media outlets. And I hope you'll tune in next week for the latest episode of the Arthritis Coach podcast, available every Wednesday morning at 4 a.m. Pacific on your favorite podcast channel. Thank you so much, and I hope you have a lovely week. If you're in the United States or possibly even around the world these days, happy Halloween. Have fun. Stay away from the candy. And I will talk to you next week. Bye-bye.